Call my way out here. You know hospitals freak me out.
It's time to grow up, Erin.
I don't know why we're even doing this. You hate him. I've only seen him like 5 times in my entire life.
Right, let's get you sorted. Who's left you in this mess?
Mum.
Oh, thanks. Look, Dad. Erin's here. We got the first train up when we heard. You don't look half as bad as I imagined. Anyway, I bought you some nice flowers. Cheer the place up a bit, nice bit of colour. I might just tidy away a few things on here, because not a lot of room. Dad, you haven't taken your pills.
I'll speak to the nurse about that.
Oh. Born in this house.
I don't think we should be doing this. He isn't even dead yet. What about this?
It's all junk, bin it.
I think it's a diary.
Well, you don't read someone else's diary, Erin. It's private.
Which one's him?
That one.
Where's it taken?
Palestine. It's what they used to call Israel. And he was stationed there.
Granddad taught you that, didn't he?
With this knife.
It's funny you said he was in Israel. Eliza's got to go out there to do her national service.
Thought she was British.
She's got dual nationality. Actually, she's asked me to go out with her. For the summer.
When?
On Monday.
Monday? What about your work experience?
I can still do that. It's just for like a couple of months, just while she does her basic training.
No.
No? What do you mean, no?
I mean, no. You're not well enough.
Mum, I'm fine. I'm not even...
Now, in any way, it's too dangerous.
It's not. They live miles away from that. Eliza, it's like this really... Cool
Eliza place. Isn't my daughter. You are. And I want you to have a proper plan for your gap year, not bumming around with your friends in a war zone. Anyway, I need your help here with Grandad.
That's so unfair. It's my fucking gap year. I'll go if I want.
Please don't use that language with me, Erin. And for once in your life, why don't you try doing something for someone else? Something that's not about what you...
I am doing this for someone else. I'm doing it for Eliza.
I just told her I was going to Israel to have seen a mass of sex, and she said, totally fine.
You will, you
know? Yeah, right. So not true.
Yeah, you will.
Stop it, idiot.
Have your chair.
Shut up.
Have that cherry.
Can you hang that up for me? Jules, cheers. Oh. Thanks for doing this, Rin. It means a lot. Yeah, it's like a major pain in the ass. I get shit out by the pool while you learn how to kill people. By the way, did you tell your parents?
Yeah.
No, I mentioned it. It's cool.
It's the 21st of April in the year of our civilization, 1945. The worst day of my life so far. We buried 1,700 bodies today, and not since we arrived. Some sights in this war. I thought I could take pretty much anything. But this makes me want to vomit, to weep. On average, 500 a day are dying, and 500 a day will continue to die, whatever we do. They bust us in to a place called Bergen-Belsen, straight from the front line. We thought we were going to be a cushy number, taking over a prison camp abandoned by the retreating German army. Imagine a wild, windswept landscape, and dust everywhere, catching in your eyes, your throat, making it hard to see, making you wonder what it is you're breathing in. A barbed wire fence stretches as far as the eye can see. Inside are 60,000 prisoners. Men, women, and children. Once they were ordinary, decent people just like us. Now they're reduced to the state of animals. Sanitation has completely broken down, so the poor wretches do the business where they stand. Typhus rages through the camp, and the inmates have neither the strength, nor in many cases the will to resist it. Everyone at home could see what I've seen. They might then understand why we've been fighting this war. Bergen-Belsen. I found it hard to celebrate. Just wanted to be on my own. My thoughts were with those of my friends and comrades who had bought this victory hard, with their lives. Apart from any personal feelings, it's difficult to think of peace when surrounded by so much human misery. And I doubt if it's as simple as burning down a few huts. The damage that's been done here can't be so easily repaired.
My granddad liberated a concentration camp in the war. I had no idea.
Erin.
Hi. Can I hug you two? I feel I know you so well.
Welcome.
Thank you.
You should watch the sun go down over the Mediterranean on your first day in Israel.
L'chaim.
L'chaim.
Cheers.
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 While you're here, we want you to treat this as your own home, Erin. Is that okay?
Not what I expected.
You thought we all lived in bomb shelters.
It's like paradise.
Yeah, I guess.
You have no idea.
There are some really, really hot guys here.
I know.
Are you okay?
Why?
You're taking medication.
Are you even starting to sound like my mother? Jeez, give me a break.
Do you want some breakfast?
You are joking.
Also known as the Holy Land, ruled by Britain under the League of Nations mandate since Allenby threw out the Ottomans in 1917. Jews and Arabs have lived here together in relative harmony since biblical times.
Is he a creep?
However, Jews fleeing Nazi persecution started arriving in numbers in the 1930s. Our victory in Europe has turned this exodus into a flood. Many are coming straight from the concentration camps in every kind of rust bucket imaginable, most completely unseaworthy. You should be aware that these Jews see returning to the Holy Land as a fulfillment of a promise made to them by God. The Arabs, who have lived here for 1,000 years, see things a little differently. Our job is to settle them down, get them living peacefully together again, to be the meat in the sandwich between the Jews and the Arabs, if you like.
Being sent back with a ship. Because I'm Jewish, isn't it?
It wouldn't be right, Alec. They'd say the same if you were an Arab.
Not any Arabs in the company, Sarge.
I thought you'd like to get off home early anyway. This trip sounds like a pot of cold piss.
Don't just fuck off and leave the lads, Sarge. Been together since Arnhem. Please don't make me. I'm a British soldier, same as you.
Let's round them up!
Seen this picture somewhere before.
This way.
Vielleicht mein Mann, mein Kinderlach ist dort. Nee, vielleicht.
I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. This way.
Sorry.
Name?
Anna Fred.
Wann sind Sie geboren?
In Wien.
Wann?
Am 6. April 1920.
Nein. What's that? In welchem Lager sind Sie gewesen?
In Mauthausen.
Dresden? In Independence. Wo sind Sie an Bord gegangen?
In Triest.
Are you with him?
Sind Sie von Österreich nach Triest gekommen?
Sudan. Ja. Nash. What is he anyway? Some kind of German.
He's Czech.
What's wrong with your arm?
You.
Oh.
Name.
Mate.
Speak up. Name.
Mate.
What's this?
Mate.
What is this? Is this yours?
Proszę pana, zostawcie mnie. Ja muszę być tu.
Ralph, go!
Oi! Stand still!
The government quota on Jewish immigration exists for very good, practical reasons, Sergeant. I shouldn't have to remind you of that.
No, sir.
We expect you to set an example in these matters, not take the lead in disobeying what was a very clear order.
Yes, sir.
John. Sergeant Matthews was part of the team that went into the camp at Bergen-Belsen. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
How long were you in there?
6 weeks, sir.
Stand at ease, Sergeant. I expect it was pretty grim.
Yes, sir.
Well, then your attitude is perhaps a little more understandable. But every time we let one of these characters slip by us, we increase the chance of further open insurrection by the Arabs, who see these Jews as stealing their land. And I don't have to tell you who'll be stuck in the middle of a civil war breaks out between the Arabs and the Jews, do I, Sergeant?
No, sir.
7 days loss of privileges.
I know there has to be a quota. And that this little land can't take every Jew who suffered at the hands of the Nazis. But I think if I'd been through what these people have been through, I'd want a homeland too. I didn't like what we were asked to do today. None of us did. These people have suffered enough. But we responded with barbed wire and baseball bats. It went right.
Another gate round the back. My brother's there. It's one of the demonstrators.
Where? Which one?
When do I get to meet this famously sexy brother?
Never. Anyway, you'd hate him. He's completely insane.
Dude, if these morons can do it, you so can.
They seem like morons to me too, Rin. That's the whole point. I know you think it's like idyllic, happy families out here, but it's total bullshit. I've been to school in England since I was 8 years old. I come here for holidays. I can barely speak the language, for God's sake. There's no way I can stick this for 2 years.
Okay, here's the deal. You hate it, I'll come and get you.
We make a dash for the border. What do you reckon?
Well, I had no choice, did I? Everyone already thinks you're a puff. This is Lynn. He's a bit shy. This is Zephora.
Hello, Sergeant.
And this is Clara.
How do you do?
Hello. What's up?
Club.
Yeah.
What do you think of it?
That's okay.
Don't be taken in. It's all just propaganda.
What do you mean?
There are 100,000 British soldiers in Palestine. For the city, that's 100,000 opportunities. So shocked.
I've just got no idea what you're talking about.
It isn't complicated. The clubs are to generate support for our desire for a homeland. When you came through that door, you were a stranger. And if I do my job properly, by the time you leave, you'll be a friend. Then you write home to your family. Tell them how well you're being treated by the Jews in Palestine. Multiply that by 100,000 times.
So this is a job?
Certainly. I had to take courses in table manners and exams in English to get in.
Someone pays you?
Of course. The city pays me. What? Ask me. I have been trained to answer all your questions.
Well, I was just wondering if... what if some of the lads might not, you know, misunderstand your role?
I don't know. I finished my training this morning. You're my first light.
She asked me around for tea. Oh, you're in there, mate. No, I'm not. It's with her family. It's part of her job.
Fucking hell.
I've got that right on the head.
All Zionists.
Meet your mum and dad.
This is a song for all the British soldiers listening out there. Stop enforcing your government's illegal immigration quotas. Stop intercepting our ships and putting our refugees in concentration camps. Have they not suffered enough? Stop behaving like Nazis.
Wankers. We're the Nazis who've I been fighting for the last 5 years. Jack, just go around them.
Gotcha.
Where is everybody?
Just keep your eyes peeled.
Welcome to Kiryat Chaim.
We have orders to search the village for weapons.
Look wherever you want. We have no secrets.
There's Robbins.
Supposed to be an intelligence officer, is he?
You called it off.
What do you mean you called it off?
They knew we were coming. There was no point.
The place was deserted. They must have moved everything out last night.
I don't get it. No one in the company knew about the search before this morning.
Probably got nothing to do with it. Take a look in there. What'd you see?
Nothing. Clerks.
See any Arabs?
No.
That's right. Roundtree decided to search Kiryat Chaim 6 days ago. The order came through this office. What do you expect? They're all local Jews. It leaks like a sieve. They know everything we're doing. Usually before we do.
Bring her to me.
See you later.
Sorry, Sarge.
So now you know we are originally from Berlin. You must tell us where you are from, Sergeant.
From Yorkshire. Leeds. Max.
And your parents are still living there?
No. At least I don't think so.
You don't think so?
Papa, please stop interviewing him. You must forgive him. He thinks he's still working for the Berliner Morgenpost.
Fine, I don't mind. I was adopted. I grew up in an orphanage. I don't know what happened to my parents.
That's very sad. When you are demobbed, you must go back and look for them.
I won't be demobbed. I'm not a conscript. I'm a 30-year man. Where I come from, it would join the army or go down the pit. I chose the army.
I feel sorry for you not knowing your family. Without my daughter, I would not be sitting here. I would never have survived. You like Clara?
I do, yeah.
Then you must come again. Meet some of our friends. You could tell us all about Stella Maris place. What your boys could have between there. We often wonder. Yes, of course. Goodbye then, Sergeant.
Bye.
Maybe it was just a casual remark.
I don't think so, sir. There was something about the way he said it. It was pointed. Like he was saying, if you want to be friends with my daughter, there's a price.
Hmm.
We could feed him some old rubbish. String him along.
No. He's just a little rabbit, seizing an opportunity. We need to flesh out the fox. You told him you were sympathetic to the Jewish cause.
Not in so many words, no, sir.
You should. Be open. Hmm. Tell him you have access to a great deal of very sensitive information and you're happy to meet his friends. But not at the apartment. It's not safe.
Okay.
The Jews have been granted permission to protest against the quotas, next week. No doubt it will be noisy and well attended as usual. Suggest meeting there, amongst the crowd.
What, I stand out like a sore thumb, sir?
I wasn't suggesting you went in uniform, Sergeant. Dress in civvies. Be a Jew for the day.
You are angry.
I am, yeah. Most of us are on your side, you know.
You think we're being ungrateful?
If I'm honest, yeah. Yeah, I do. After all we did for you in the war.
You fought the war for your empire and not for us. Do you want one?
No, thanks. Did your mother die in the war?
No. She's still alive. Met someone else in the camps. I think she's in Italy now. So you see, not every concentration camp story is an unhappy ending. At least for her.
I'm sorry.
Logitech! then?
Are you with
him? Come, we cannot talk to you. Too many eyes and ears.
Sorry, mate. There was no way we could warn you. That was Yakov Marzel. We've been after him for months.
So think I'll double-cross them.
No, they won't. It was a riot. We fired to disperse
the crowd. Oh, that's fucking bollocks. You set me up, you bastards.
Yeah, well, that's the way Roundtree wanted it. And if you don't like it, take it up with him.
Hi. You must be Aaron. I'm Paul, Liza's brother.
Hi.
Hi. What are you reading?
My granddad's diary. He was stationed here after the war. He was a British soldier.
Did you know our grandfather wasn't Irgun? It's the underground army that fought the British. He killed a lot of people like your grandfather.
What's the point? What do you mean, what's the point? The point is, it's wrong, and it should be challenged in the courts like in any other civilized country. But you know what happened at Berlin?
Do we have to talk politics?
They built the wall right across the village land. The Palestinians couldn't get to their fields to harvest their crops. So what did we do? We protested. We wrote letters. We took them to the Supreme Court, all the things my son thinks are a complete waste of time. And do you know what the court did? It told the government to move the wall and give the Palestinians back their land.
Yeah, a tiny part of their land.
And they did. They dug it up and rebuilt it.
Yeah, and for every time when the court sides with the Palestinians in the full blaze of publicity, there are 100 cases which no one ever hears about where they side with the government. Where they throw out the appeal and legitimize the land grab. It doesn't help. It's actually his cozy liberal opposition that's perpetuating this fucking occupation.
Hey, it's not my anything, Paul, okay? Fucking or otherwise.
Max.
And how do we perpetuate it by opposing it? You'll have to explain that to me.
What do you think when you hear about all these petitions and rallies? What does it make you think?
I don't know.
Okay, enough. I mean, I want some more.
It makes you think Israel is a society like yours. That's how protest helps the occupation. By making the world think that this is a functioning democracy, that you can change anything here by political action.
But weren't you protesting the other day? We saw you outside the army base.
Exactly. He should take a look around the rest of the Middle East if he doesn't think Israel's a democracy. What are we, I'd like to know, if not a democracy?
A military dictatorship.
Look, come on, Paul, don't be silly. This country is run by politicians, not the army.
Yeah, and you know who all these wonderful politicians are, Aaron? Begin, Shamir, Rabin, Barak, Sharon. They're all ex-generals. The army controls every aspect of our lives, our roads, our transport, our borders. They mess with our kids' education, and their leaders end up in government. What else is that but a military state?
What? They always like that. Why do you think I live in England? Does Paul hate your dad? Not really. It's just complicated. Why? Tell me. What's the point? Just the usual macho bullshit. My dad's this really famous liberal, okay? When he was a general, he signed a letter criticising the occupation. It was a really big deal at the time. Your dad was a general? Yeah. But Paul's a liberal, isn't he? I don't get it. He used to be really pro-military to annoy Dad. And then the army sent him to Hebron. I think he had a really rough time there. When he came out, he was suddenly this super hardline anti-Zionist. And I told you, it's completely insane. What does he do now? Oh, I don't know. He volunteers for these really weird ex-military pressure groups. Mostly he just sponges off my parents. Apart from that, you really like him. You're so crap at that. Can you? Oh, cheers. I just know any minute now you're going to ask me how my first week in the army was. Oh, please. Tell me all about your first week in the army, Eliza.
It was a total fucking nightmare, but thank you for asking.
They were minding their own business, protesting peacefully, which they have every legal right to do, when without warning...
Oh, Trace, do we have to listen to that shit again, Sarge?
One man was shot dead, and many others were injured in the panic which followed. These were unarmed civilians trying to peacefully demonstrate against your government's illegal immigration quotas, and you shot them dead in the street. Shame on you, Tommy. Shame on you.
What a load of bollocks.
Oh, that's fucking disgusting!
Back up, back home, then!
Oi! Sergeant Chamber Pot.
Not straight in. Oi, you can quit now.
Right. Stop too long. Get dried off, yeah?
What's your next?
Well, she's what this house.
Thank you.
Can you hear me?
Kérem, kimenni!
Did you look at any of them?
No, sir. They just shot the lads and ran. I wondered if you thought it were retaliation, sir, for what happened at the demonstration.
Possibly. Perhaps you should postpone your visit tonight.
It's fine, sir.
The following communique has been received from the Irgun Svei Lumi. Today, 11th October 1945. Six British soldiers from the Parachute Regiment were killed in combat by forces of the National Military Organization. All our soldiers returned unharmed to their bases. The Nazi British occupation forces have responded with a curfew which...
I thought he might be caught out by the curfew.
I'm very sorry about what happened to your friends today. It was quite wrong. Shameful. But it doesn't alter the fact that you are no longer welcome in my house. I'm sure you know why.
That had nothing to do with me. I promise you. I'm on your side.
We may be stateless, Sergeant, but we are not stupid.
I was afraid you were dead.
Hi.
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 Do you know where they buried the British soldiers that were killed here?
I think there's a big military cemetery at Rumne.
Would you take me?
The gambler said I'd go.
Thanks. Oh, my God.
What? What is it?
It's Robbins and Nash. I've just been reading about them. They work for Roundtree. They're friends of my granddad's.
So where are the other guys? Isn't that why we're here?
Yeah, but these two are still alive. They're going to be killed. On the 30th of July, 1947.
Doesn't say how they die. Maybe we could look it up.
He's got no idea they're going to be killed.
I need your passport.
Why? Where are we going?
Into the occupied territories.
Je vous donne des vacations. C'est bien.
I thought you were taking me home. Isn't it too dangerous?
Rather be back safely by the pool. Here, I won't be long. I joined Combatants for Peace because I realized that although I'd seen Palestinians through my weapon sights on a daily basis,
انضميت لحركة مقاتلين من أجل السلام لأنه لاحظت ما كنتش أعرف أي فلسطيني بس عن طريق عدسة السلاح.
I didn't actually know any Palestinians.
ما كنتش أعرف أي فلسطيني.
I'd never been in a Palestinian home except to search it.
ولا مرة كنت في بيت فلسطيني إلا ما فتشته.
But once you've met your former enemy,
بس تتعرف على عدوك السابق,
realized he's a human being just like you,
تلاحظ إنه هو بني آدم زيه زيك,
you can never go back,
مش ممكن ترجع لورا,
never take up the weapon again,
مش ممكن ترجع وتحمل السلاح كمان مرة,
never,
مش ممكن. Thank you, Paul. شكرا. عمر,
اسمي عمر حبش, 6 سنوات قتلت مع شهداء الأقصى.
My name is عمر حبش. I fought 6 years with the Al-Aqsa martyrs.
الناس بيحكوا لي شو قصتك يا عمر.
People say to me, what's the matter with you, Omar?
ليش عم تحكي مع العدو؟
Why are you talking to the enemy?
وأنا بحكي لهم.
And I say,
سنوات حرب.
I spent 6 years fighting them.
أخوي من قبل حاربهم وقضى 3 سنوات بالسجن.
My brother fought them and spent 3 years in their jails.
أبوي استشهد وهو يحارب فيهم.
My father died fighting them.
صار لنا 60 سنة بنحاربهم وبعدنا ما تحررنا.
For 60 years we have fought them and still we aren't free.
وهم صار لهم 60 سنة بيحاربونا وبعدهم بحسوش بالأمان.
60 years they have fought us and still they don't feel safe.
أول مرة بتقعد مع عدوك عشان تحاول تنهي الاحتلال رح تكون صعبة.
The first time you sit down with your enemy to try to end this occupation, it's going to be difficult.
لأنه هذا نفس الشخص اللي كان يعذبك.
It's the same person who tortured you.
وحاول يقتلك.
The same person who tried to kill you.
بس أنا اللي بقوله.
But I say,
إنه إذا إحنا المقاتلين,
if we, the fighters,
اللي كنا ألد الأعداء,
we who were the most bitter of enemies,
نقعد مع بعضنا,
can't sit down together,
ليش ما تدكوا أنتوا كمان؟
Why can't you?
وإذا نجحنا نسلم على بعضنا,
if we can shake hands,
ليش ما تسلموا أنتوا كمان؟
Why can't you?
Sorry to be thick, but why are we taking him back into Israel?
Ask him. He speaks English.
My home is on the other side of the wall.
Omar is an Israeli Arab. He has the same rights as Eliza and me, in theory. Omar, don't. It's not worth it.
Why are you doing that for us?
Avali,
why?
Shoot, shoot.
What are you doing? Go, go. What are you doing?
Вели туда.
Yaklaşan. Yaklaşan.
Am wenn wir reden, Juan. Rokenta kesin. Yala Rokenta kesin, no? Yala yala.
Alo. Alo Hayal. תגיד לי, מה אתה חושב שאתה עושה? אני מכיר את הבן אדם, קוראים לו עומר חבש, הוא חבר שלי. הלו, אני מדבר אליך, מה אתה עושה?
גו. גו עובר. יאללה, נצא, גו, גו, גו.
מה אתה עושה? לאן אתה שולח אותו?
גו. הלו, הלו, אני מדבר אליך.
הו, לוק אאוט!
תן לי שנייה, בסדר?
خلاص انت عملت ايه طيب هي تتجروا تخنوا قلت لي نتقبل بزين
عمر انا قلت الناس انا يا جماعه انا وصلت لي تن لي شويه بسطر
احنا صفقين متاخره زي كل الحايم
عمر انا يودا
انا يودا ما انا وصلت
ظبطت انا يلا يلا توس توس من هنا
wants us to go, okay? The longer we stand here, the more of a hard time that we're going to give him. It's his decision.
Will he be okay?
No, we've gone. They'll most likely get bored and let him go. Ring in an hour. Make sure he's home. Welcome to Israel, Aaron. Just got a crash course in what it means to be a Palestinian in this fucking country.
Isn't it to stop terrorists getting into Israel?
Do you know what that is? It's a Palestinian village. Do you know what that is? That's another Palestinian village. That one's outside the checkpoint, that one's inside the checkpoint. Which one does the terrorist come from? You tell me. The village outside the wall or the one that is already inside? The checkpoints are there for one reason, to make their lives impossible so they'll give up and move away. It's about control, humiliation, and forcing them off their land. It's got nothing to do with terrorism. Nothing. Sorry, I shouted. You're having to play catch up pretty fast in this insane country of ours, aren't you?
I like it here.
Well, that's because you live in the safe little world of my parents.
Why are you so down on them?
Because they're part of the problem.
That's so unfair. They're some of the kindest, most generous people I've ever met.
You're right. They are. You know, when I was 10 years old, my father took me to see the border. The Jewish side was green and fertile, and the Arab side was brown and barren with a few goats. And then he said to me, and this was this big lesson he wanted me to remember. He said, look what they've done with the land in 2,000 years. Look what we achieved in 50. And this is a good man. A liberal man. It took me years to learn to question the assumptions behind the things he said to me that day. They are not as deserving as we are. They do nothing with the land. They're animals. They hate us. Shit, I left my wallet on the table. Get in, I'll be right back.
Mm-hmm.